Welcome, everyone, to the final update of JoJo's Bizarre Adventure.
And JoJo wept because there are no more bizarre adventures to be had.
Yeah, from now on, the big thing is, like, JoJo's just gonna be, like, it's gonna be, like, going to the grocery store. It's gonna be, like, going to the DMV, right? Like, there's just nothing exciting anymore after this particular one.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, we did see Narancia try to go to the grocery store to a very, like, comical result.
Yeah, to be fair, that was pretty bizarre. I'm not gonna disagree with you.
You guys may see it more as double off of comedy, but I see it much more as the evil, dramatic.
Yeah, drama is evil.
I like Breaking Bad when it was funny. I hate it when Walt was sad.
And damn, he was sad a lot.
Yeah.
He's like, my family hates me, so I have to be a worse person.
Oh, my family hates me, and I'm like, shut up, get stuck on the toilet again, bitch.
I mean, that's why all the drama club kids had to be bullied all the time. I mean, they were fucking bringing negativity into the world.
Right, bad vibes. So when he throws the pizza on the roof, is that an evil drama or is that a good comedy?
Oh, that is evil drama for sure, because it destroyed, like, the housing situation of the people who actually lived in that house.
It's true, I think even to this day.
Right, so Bryan Cranston had to buy the house and move in.
And now he's like, oh, free pizza, he eats it.
Yeah, he just sits up on the roof in a little lawn chair and catches the pizza when they throw it up there.
I'm still so sad that he's just got, like, a normal telephone in this.
Well, you know, you can't fool Bruno if you pull out, like, a fucking frog and call on it.
Sure. Here you're like, oh, this is a cellular phone. It's like, oh, I've never heard of that before. It must be an American thing.
Also, you know, that's the thing. Game designers, they are evil and they love drama, so that's why they would never put in a funny phone.
Right, because they hate comedy.
Yeah.
Yeah, originally, his stand was gonna be Raffi's banana phone, but they had to change it for legal reasons.
Oh, sure, yeah, because Raffi was like, you do this, I'm gonna fucking come to your house.
Seems Raffi there drunk a little of the drama himself.
Yeah. Oh no, they clipped through the floor! We can't finish the quest!
Ah! Oh, is that guy from the Super Famicom JoJo's Bizarre Adventure game?
It is! Oh man, are they gonna do it? Oh, hell yeah. I'm just so glad to see that fucking transition. It's so good. Man, he is looking worse for wear, though, in a lot of these shots.
Yeah, but I was gonna kind of say the same about Polaris' legs. I had not really seen how fucked up they are like that.
They've been through a lot. And unfortunately, it's not over for him.
Yeah.
I really like how the Apollo is presented in this game, because he just looks like a fucking smuck. Like, all the dramatic shit he does feels, like, so deflated.
Yeah. He just looks like a lot more of a dirtbag, right? Like, less menacing and more just, like, an asshole?
Yeah. Oh, man.
It's time for wheelchair pull.
You gotta kill him! Oh, wow, this is gonna be just like Final Fantasy VII. How's it? So, okay. Oh, no!
Oh, six,
fuck
six,
yeah,
six.
Man.
Oh, I didn't realize they were missing off of the stand, too. Holy shit.
So, yeah, the two secret factors in this are just hitting the Apollo with your stand brush and hitting the Apollo stands.
Cool, hell yeah. You know, I appreciate that, like, at some point, they're just like, yeah, you know what, it's really fucking easy. Here are the things that you have to do. Hit them. Oh, nice!
Oh, man.
Oh, that's so cool. I love that time still moves during this section, so you totally can't just hit him if you're already in an attack.
Also, I like that you get the blood on your screen like you got the blooper power-up in Mario Kart.
Here's another take. If Polnareff's stand gauge is, like, completely drained, he just fucking sits there on the floor depressed as fuck until it refills.
Well, there's nobody to pick him up!
There's so much, like... I don't know. It just feels like this particular fight somehow has, like, a lot more character than a lot of the other fights. And maybe, and I think this is maybe true of, like, the fight on the plane as well. It's just, like, they've added, like, some very weird, interesting mechanics in that are, like, less obnoxious than early on.
Yeah, I think the simplicity of it really goes in its favor, because I feel the more complicated it's gotten, the harder it's been for them to really incorporate it into the gameplay properly, whereas, I mean, this is a fight where Polnareff is just going to get his fucking ass whipped, so...
I just love the way it looks when he dashes and when he does the...
I mean, his fucking wheelchair tricks are very good.
He could not make it there fast enough. Damn, buddy, this is cool.
Yeah, Polnareff in his action wheelchair is probably the best part of this entire game.
This is great. I love that he can barely hit you on the ground, too. Like, he has to get through his full combo to do it.
Yeah, not even like a stand combo. A stand combo can't fucking get you on the ground.
All right, his stand's floating like 3 inches off the ground, so he's in a bad position.
Fucking Diavolo's face in that freeze frame made him look like the Undertaker.
Otoroete wa inai no ka? Sono seishinryu, taimingu mo tensaiteki da.
If you weren't always lying on the ground.
Diablo is saying that his spiritual energy is very strong because also in between parts, Polnareff became a devout Catholic.
Well, I mean, win in Rome.
It's true.
Yeah.
Polnareff looks more like a devout Protestant.
Oh, maybe. Yeah, I feel like Catholic would be, like, a little too, like, restrictive for what he wants to do.
Listen, you saw how depressed he was on the floor. He wants to worship a god depressed as hell, too.
Right, yeah.
Yeah. What we don't see is that, Jotaro became a Calvinist.
Damn, that's fucked up. Jotaro's too busy on logic. That's why his wife left him. Wow, sounds like a lot of stuff happened off screen that maybe would have been interesting to see, but oh well. Die.
That's like a shirt he's wearing. It's not like tattoos, is it?
Yeah, I think it's all just mesh.
It looks like it's like half of one and half the other.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's like a weird mesh thing.
Hey! Hey!
Hey, I'm talking to you. Very interested to see how the game handles this.
Yeah.
Well, I'll just tell you out right now, it's not fun.
Damn!
I figured so, but...
I hope you play as, like, the man who turned into the dog and the dog that turned into the man.
Oh man, yeah, what if you had to play as all of the, like, citizens and you had to all gather together to fucking, like, kill him?
You have to play as a guy who gets turned into his dog.
Yeah.
Sounds a bit like alternate universe stuff, and we ain't doing that in this game.
That's fair. We're staying strictly to the canon.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look at Mista. He's so tired. He's tuckered out.
He sleeps with a gun in his hand, too.
He totally, like, tucks his gut in under the blanket.
Oh, yeah.
Each of the Sex Pistols have their own little pillows. They actually sleep in a, like, a tuna fish can.
Whenever he goes to a hotel, he has to order, like, six other mints for his pillow to share with his Sex Pistols.
Yeah, but he just asks for one every time. He is the worst guest in the world.
He's like, I can split this up, probably. It's time. Yeah. Oh, I love the render on this turtle.
Yeah. So I know this is probably not going to happen, but after seeing the fight where you actually get to play as Polnareff in the wheelchair, now I'm, you know, hoping but not expecting a fight as the turtle.
Oh, yeah, you have a move where you bite onto the guy's finger and you just don't let go.
I was thinking it could be, like, the fight's going on and, like, it switches perspective to Polnareff, and you have to do basically, like, the Metal Gear Solid 4 walk all the way to see what's going on.
Unfortunately, the only thing needed to render a turtle for gameplay purposes was cell processing, so that ain't happening.
Damn.
Do we know where these arrows come from? Are they, like, alien technology?
Yeah. Well, they don't explain in the game, but they explained it in the anime, right? Where it was, like, made out of a fucking meteorite or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's some weird, like, alien fires. It's a really boring answer, so I forget about it every time.
It's the real midichlorians of JoJo's.
Do you think that's where the vampire mask also comes from? It's just another meteorite thing?
No! No, we saw that one. That was an Aztec ritual. Or a Mayan ritual.
But maybe they got it from aliens?
I don't know, that sounds a little far-fetched.
Giorno, why are you using Naranja's ability? This doesn't make any sense.
I just love this slow ass run. Also, get the huge glow down from Bruno's model.
I just love that he's running, but he's not moving.
They don't show it, but he's actually slipping on a bunch of peas. They had to remove the Flintstone sound, though. Oh, damn, okay.
So, I really don't like this fight. The big gimmick behind it is that, Chariot Requiem just kind of walks, like, to the end of this hallway, and if he actually, like, walks out of it, you lose.
Yeah.
But also, he's got, like, sticky fingers with him, and sticky fingers is, like, a son of a bitch to actually fight in this.
Oh, no. You were having such a good time playing as him, you never thought the idea of having to play against him.
Perfectly symmetrical violence. Also, I really love that it was, like, 50 meters until Chariot Requiem dominates all souls. 50 meters until he pwns everyone. You got kind of like a strategy here, though. It can only punch in one direction, so you just run around.
So, basically the entire best strategy against this fight to not get completely fucking owned by Sticky Fingers, who now knows Sunny combos, is to just run circles around him like a child and then headbutt him like every time you complete a circle.
Wow, this really doesn't make any sense in the context of the manga. I don't think this isn't really how it worked.
It's like, I guess it's like the closest approximation they could do without having to, like, I don't know, give Requiem moves or animations. But yeah, this seems more annoying than it is fun, for sure.
I think that was, like, the tagline for the video game.
More annoying than fun, but it is JoJo, so you know.
Nope, where are you going?
Right into a trap.
He's trying to dodge it, but you know.
I love getting the... when people get the big zippers on them.
It's like the 90s all over again.
The big zippers are kind of useless for you in this fight, because I noticed whenever they like hit Sticky Fingers instead of Requiem, Sticky Fingers just kind of fucking ignores it.
Oh, great. Does it even really do anything to Requiem? It seems like Requiem's just been kind of like unperturbed unless you like get a really good solid hit in.
It does slow him down a bit, and usually leaves him open for attack, but good luck doing that and not getting hit by Sticky Fingers in return.
Sure. Yeah, it seems annoying. Sticky Fingers disappeared at one point. Is there, like, an invisible health meter for the Sticky Fingers stand?
I mean, every enemy has, like, their stand meter.
Okay.
And, like, eventually runs out, but no, that was just Sticky Fingers ignoring the zipper attack.
Okay.
Since this is evil Sticky Fingers, I think we should call him Stanky Fingers.
Stanky Leg.
I don't think we should.
Nano, what's the opposite of Sticky Fingers? Like, I don't know, Sergeant Peppers?
Normal Fingers.
It's actually Zipper Man.
Salad Fingers. Folks, I got it. It's Chicken Fingers. Thanks. I'm out.
I love the idea of missing somebody, but it's like, well, actually, I was just punching in the air for exercise. I wasn't trying to hit you.
Especially when you are trapped in a single space. It's very funny. Oh my god, you almost got him. Yeah!
Were there any secret factories for that?
Yeah, it was just once again hitting Requiem and then hitting the stand he's using.
Oh, okay.
Hit him hard. Hit him harder.
There's a certain kind of goals you often see if they just kind of ran out of stuff to do for the actual secret characters.
Cool.
I think you might have noticed by now what they are.
No, in the manga, he hit Requiem and then he hit the Sticky Fingers. It makes sense.
どうすんだよ。ミスター、やつの体が目覚めたぞ。起き上がる。今は矢の追跡は後だ。ミスター、見て、やつを。やったか。今、時間が数秒消し飛んだぞ。あいつは本当にディアボロなのか。答えはわからないが、今時が消し飛んだというのなら、
I love its blurry, like, motion blur.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like a picture of a cryptid. No, that's Giordo? I forgot, I can't even get these characters' names right.
That's right. What were they smoking when they wrote this one?
smoke cocaine.
I think they were smoking smoke from Mortal Kombat 3. Smoke from Mortal Kombat 3, everyone. Remember that guy?
But I think there should have been, like, a gameplay portion where you play as Narancia, like, saying about how he's gonna go back to school when all this is over.
Yeah, you have to, like, visual novel style, like, make a speech. Anyways, I'll be taking this back now.
Oh no, he's just wasted.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, okay.
I think it would be fun to have more bullies in my life.
If only he wasn't so fucking stupid, he wouldn't have died.
Hey guys, my name is John Per Polnareff. Your friend dying reminded me of multiple personality disorder.
Reminded me of demonic possession.
Yeah, like, I really like that implication that, like, Diafolo is just kind of the devil imprinting as another personality, but it doesn't really happen in this game where he just sounds like a 30-year-old man.
Yeah.
What if, a short hair boss is also just another personality, though? A short hair boss is the Heisenberg to,
yes,
Diavolo's Walter White.
Right?
Jay, that sounded more like a drama than a comedy thing to me.
Well, one of them's drama and one of them's comedy. Walter White's a comedy man. Heisenberg's a drama man.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Walter White gets stuck in the toilet. Heisenberg puts books in the toilet.
Yeah.
Heisenberg's. That's me waiting on a date.
I think it's very funny, like, that this... They're like, that guy's the villain, and they just, like, shoot him to death, and then it's like, oh, wait, that's not the guy, whoever. And they just, like, leave him. They don't care who was in the body. He's just dead.
You know, he facilitated the boss, so...
Sure. Wow, they skipped a lot of drama here, but okay. That's probably fine.
Well, that's to add in more comedy.
Right.
I don't know if that's been shown at all.
No, it's right here.
See?
God, this is so fucking stupid.
No, this is metaphor. That means it's smart.
Imagine playing this and having never engaged with any kind of JoJo's media ever before.
Well, let me tell you, originally they were planning to bring this to America, so it might have happened.
Yeah, I remember, like, I feel like I saw G4 talk about this game and be like, oh, there's a plane named Aerosmith. Oh, this is so wacky.
That does sound like very G4, so I believe it. Mm-hmm. So now that we're at the end, do you think that this is more or less comprehensible than the Super Nintendo game?
I think it's more comprehensible, honestly.
Okay.
Like, at least it kind of, like, shows the story, even though it's, like, truncated in, like, the least interesting way possible.
Right, sure.
At least there aren't, like, vampires every 5 feet.
In the final battle of this game, you do get a think button.
I will say, yeah, there does, like, seems to be a lot more story here. Though they are skipping a bunch of shit, because he's just going to heaven now.
Mm-hmm.
And even then, there's still more effort to, like, translate JoJo into a video game than that Part 3 game tried.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you talk about skipping over a lot of stuff in this one, but the SNES one, I feel like the amount of stuff that was skipped over in that one was, like, even in comparison to this one, was orders of magnitude, like, it skipped a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it definitely captures the spirit a lot better in this game, and yeah, it's definitely, like, you can tell that there is a story here that they just couldn't put all of it in. Where in the JoJo's Part 3 SNES game, I'm not even quite sure there's a story there.
And also, you have to remember, for the fights that you can play, they've got, like, audio dramas of them you can unlock.
Yeah. Which is, like, again, you get more of the story.
Sorry, the side view of Trisha's mouth as she spoke was deeply upsetting.
Deeply upsetting, too, is Golden Experience Requiem. Bad luck. Though, I gotta say, it looks a lot better than the Jump Force one.
Yeah.
I like that he just looks like he's really frustrated about something, like, 24/7.
It's like his cat climbed up onto, like, the grandfather clock, and he's chastising it.
Gold Experience Requiem is also mad that Walter White doesn't get stuck in the toilet anymore.
Oh, yeah? I like Diavolo's, like, pose in that loading screen where it's just like, he's like, what do you want me to do for this? And they just caught him, like, that's good.
His whole mannerism at the moment is very much he went into the gas station store to get a taquito, and the guy behind the counter was being mean to him. He goes back to the car and imagines all the ways he could be, like, super badass back at him.
What are you doing? What is this?
I'm shooting scorpions at Diafalo.
Is that really what it is? They're scorpions?
Yeah.
Oh, that rocks?
Press X to scorpion.
Fucking Golden Experience is the dumbest stand ever.
So, there are three secret factors in this. One you just get at the beginning of the stage. The other is shooting Diafalo with a scorpion and actually hitting. And another is, like, surviving one of his time slowdowns without taking damage.
Oh, cool.
I love that being like, don't get cocky. Well, you just, like, absolutely dominate the shit out of him.
So, yeah. Another thing about the slowdown is, even though Giorno moves very slow in it, Requiem actually has the normal speed.
Yeah, I saw that. Like, when you just, like, shot him with 15 scorpions.
And it's time to do it again.
I also like that your animation is literally just, like, all the frames are halved. You're just moving at half frame rate. It's cool.
Yeah, I actually really like the actual fights against Diafalo in this game. I think they're neat.
The effect is cool, and they give you some cool powers. Like, one, you can either have the action wheelchair, or two, you can have your fucking action scorpions.
I think this is cool because it doesn't seem anything like Diavolo's stand power, but I guess, like, that's so hard to, like, replicate. They're just like, it's sort of like Dia.
Right, like, it would basically just be like, oh, it stops you for 5 seconds and he moves around, right? Which is, like, not interesting.
Yeah. It's not interesting, and also, it's probably very frustrating when actually playing a video game.
Yeah. Aw, nice. Oh, man. This is like, this is like some blind firing shit. This is great.
Honestly, it's kind of boring also, but it's probably the best way to deal with Diafolo.
Are there any other attacks that he has, or is it basically just scorpion shoot?
Basically, he's got most of, like, the melee rushes that, like, Rector Gold Experience has, but then he also just has the scorpion shoot, yeah?
That would be so great if that was the only change to Golden Experience Requiem. It's just like, now I can shoot scorpions!
He's just, like, flicking scorpions at you like he's flicking paper clips in the middle of class.
I, like, don't even remember how the scorpions happened in, like, the anime or manga. Was it just like, oh, I threw a rock at you and then it turned into a scorpion, like I can kind of already do.
Yeah, because I feel like this is not actually the thing about his power, right?
Yeah.
This is just to give you a projectile move.
Well, I mean, the thing about his power is that the fight doesn't even happen.
Well, it's because when time was stopped, he shot a million scorpions at Diavolo, killing him instantly. Just so much poison in his veins immediately. Damn, he's really holding on to this last sliver of health.
Oh, yeah, but he didn't see the last of it.
Oh, my God! Wait, he just recovers health? What an asshole!
Yeah, he only does this once, okay, though, and just shoot him with the scorpion, like, 12 times, and that's it.
Like, it doesn't even look like a scorpion. Oh, okay, I can kind of see the scorpion, but they just look like glowing lights.
I thought you were gonna say that if you didn't kill him with a scorpion, he automatically reheals over and over. Imagine how sad this must be as Diavolo to have died because 3 million scorpions were shot into your fucking face.
The devil goes back to hell and his soul got gut by scorpions.
The greatest mafioso who ever lived died of 1,000 scorpion stings all at once.
Who's the deadliest warrior? Al Capone or 15 dozen scorpions?
I don't know if the scorpion even got to sting him. He just fucking threw them at him.
Well, Al Capone famously did get taken down by a bunch of scorpions who were looking for tax evasion.
And that infected him with syphilis.
Right.
I'm sorry, guys. I don't want to get into politics with the FBI at this moment.
Understandable. Well, he fell in the famous Italian poo water, so he'll never come back alive.
It'd be cool if Al Capone went to jail because, like, he was streaming, like, a Beyonce song while he was playing Fortnite.
Right, he gets DMCA'd. I mean, that's how I think the mafiosos of today are gonna get caught, is they're just gonna, like, get too big for their britches, they're gonna, like, I don't know, stream Shrek as a watch-along, and they're gonna get arrested.
They're gonna have their face cam on, but also The Godfather Part 2 is gonna be playing in the background.
Right.
Oh, I hope you get to play this fight.
From this angle, he just looks like a weird frog.
Do you think, like, he just, like, he did a really bad dye job, so that's why it looks like a leopard print thing?
I think because he's been, well, I mean, I guess I can't say beforehand.
Well, whoa, here's one thing about Diavolo. He loves Peggy from Married with Children. That's his idol.
Wait, the blood isn't even on him, it's floating off of him.
No, that's perfect. If I had to think of Diavolo being really into, like, I don't know, like, daytime TV, definitely Married with Children is up there.
Oh yeah, he, like, looks at the intro every time, it's like, man, I wish I could put my hands in my pants.
Al Capone, no, I'd rather be Al Bundy. Oh no, he's stuck in this animation loop.
No, that's great.
That's my new Fortnite dance.
This is the true power of King Crimson.
I want every single scene for the rest of the game, he's dancing somewhere in the distance, like a little Easter egg.
Yeah, it's like how you can find Big the Cat in Sonic Adventure 2 stages.
Right.
Oh,
あの想像を絶する苦痛は夢にしては
Yeah! Funny enough, that dog has as many polygons as the one in Lightning Returns.
Right. I love that it is a 3D model with 0 points of articulation.
Well, you know, this is still a worse game than Lightning Returns because it doesn't star gaming's greatest character, Lightning.
It's true. Lightning also famously very into like Italian clothing, and Italian fashion. This one he just gets hit by a meteor. Oh, did they not do the one on the operating table? I mean, that's fair enough. That one's fucked up, but, like...
It would be cool if, like, instead of getting hit by a car or stabbed by a hope... Oh.
Hey, let's get our butts...
This is it. This is why I'm LPing this game.
...back in his body, but he's still injured. He's probably there, lying on the floor, wondering what's become of us. Hey, Jordan... Let's go.
Yeah, if I remember when this was released, they said that they couldn't put subtitles into the final movie, so they had to dub it.
Yeah? You know what? It's great.
That'll do, Jordan.
That'll do, Pig. That'll do.
Oh, he's Jesus!
This is all her friends.
We've managed. It's amazing that they've managed to get Matthew Mercer for this fan sub.
I legitimately think this is very charming as a way to get around like the final hurdle of a translation patch.
If you forget about me, I don't know. Yeah, I take this rules. I think this is cool. I hope all these people voicing these characters have a great career.
Yeah.
I think it sucks ass that they don't have accents. Like, Polnareff should have a very thick French accent. He's like, oh, if you leave me here, I will be turtle soup.
I think Bruno tried to do an accent, and we all know how that worked out great.
Yeah.
10 out of 10 performance.
To live inside it as a ghost for a while.
As a ghost for a while. Otacon. What do turtles like to eat?
Polnareff sounds like a little too classy in this fan dub.
This is the best shot.
Manga deck staff, yeah!
I see. They don't know then?
That which we have inherited. Not manga stream, holy shit! Are we starting a fight in the fucking... credits for this fucking game?
I'm taking it to you, manga stream. You just sent your assassins after me, I'll kill them pronto.
Executive producer, not Miami Mike.
What is the duty of the survivors? Now, to the Colosseum then?
Now we're in Vatican City.
That's right, Giorno, the new pope.
Oh, they're so low res.
Yeah, they look like Castlevania 64 NPCs.
Fucking rocks.
What do you think Giorno's gotta do as, like, the new Mafia Don? Like, what's his first point of order?
Well, his first point of order is to go do the another story thing we just unlocked.
Oh!
In this... you have a certain amount of, like, characters you can't normally play and use them to do previous fights.
Oh, neat!
The only problem is, because there's no secret factors, your health bar is fucking tiny, so I'm only really doing this on Bruno.
Okay, yo! Oh, I love the juggles you've got with Fugo. Damn, remember Fugo? Wish he was in the game more?
Uh-huh.
Who?
Fugo.
Oh, the holy man?
Yeah.
He's so holy, he must have gone to Vatican City!
Yeah.
Oh, never mind. My stat got distracted. So, on top of this, another story thing is also a way to get some more points so you can unlock some more bonus stuff. Like, you know, concept art, story dramas, that sort of stuff.
Okay. Yeah, because I noticed there was, like, a rating on each of these. Okay.
Yeah. I thought about, like, showing that off, but, like, it's not that exciting. Like, you can probably find that shit on your own if you're actually interested enough.
One question about Fugo's stand. Does, like, popping his little fist bubbles, like, actually... Like, does it just, like, do, like, more damage for that one specific hit, or...
Yes.
Okay. So it's not nearly as deadly as it is in... any other form of media.
It is what it is.
They should have made that if you pop all of them, it's an insta win.
Anyway, the big problem is because there's no secret factors for these, actually getting like a decent score can be kind of hard for like the later ones.
Yeah, I can only imagine.
Yeah, in this one, it's really only hard because I am bad at video games, and also it was like 6 a.m. when I recorded this.
I would love to see you do like a 100% playthrough as a Baccio.
I'm not fucking doing that.
Did you just take the worst character ever?
It would be really great if in the final fight we got to see the like the Requiem version of all the character stands. That would be a nice touch.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's a little bit too much effort. But anyway, thank you all for watching.
I want to see Narancia have a little jumbo jet as his stand.
And see you all next time for more Let's Plays. Goodbye.
Bye.
And good night.
Bye.
Fucking love this, Jorna.